All right, on this episode of Bouts Talking Bouts, excited to be speaking with an individual head of quite the consequential and intriguing strawweight fight at ONE Heavy Hitters, which takes place on January the 14th. We have Tiffany Teo getting out there to the ONE Circle and taking on Meng Bo, and very happy to be welcoming Meng onto the show. How's your day going so far, Meng?
小波，非常欢迎你参加这档节目。你最近怎么样呢？
我最近挺好的，一直在处于备赛的期间。
I'm doing pretty good, having a pretty hard, pretty tough camp. I'm very ready, very prepared.
Yeah, and like what kind of new, I guess, additions to the camp have popped up? I mean, you mentioned it being a hard, difficult camp. You're trying to get back into the win column in a new division. Like, have there been, I guess, new aspects, you know, added to the training camp, as it were?
你是这次比赛可以说是你在ONE首次尝试草量级吧？你的这个训练的训练营，这次这个备赛的训练营，有没有和以往有什么不同呢？对，我这次是在ONE冠军赛打的是草量级，然后我这次选择了一个比较偏摔柔的一个，也不是偏摔柔吧，就是摔柔技术比较好的一个战队来备赛。 然后也是我的团队也是在对我的一些龙边或者是地面的技术都有加强。好的，好的。Yeah,
this is my first time trying strawweight in ONE Championship, and I'm actually training with a team that's more of a grappling wrestling team, and we've been preparing for some techniques of how to fight against the cage or something like that, how to grapple, how to wrestle, more like that. That's what I'm adding new in my new camp.
And I'm curious, has this idea of moving to strawweight kind of been in the picture for a little while now, or was it more just like almost get a fresh coat of paint on the career, as it were, after falling out of the ONE Atomweight Grand Prix?
你加入这个草量级，这次尝试草量级是一个长期的，就有的一个打算呢，还是说临时的这么一个决定？是不是和这个就是上一次在参加这个原子量级的八人赛，然后结果有一点不如意也有相关呢？我觉得输赢对一个运动员来说其实很正常的一件事情。然后我觉得我升级别不跟上一场输也没有关系。 然后，如果可以的话，我希望我在草量级留下，然后打出自己的一片天。Yeah,
I know I lost my last fight in the Atomweight Grand Prix, but that wasn't the reason of why I'm now jumping into strawweight. It's actually a long preparation, and I'm hoping to stay in strawweight in the future as because it's actually more fit to my body condition. That's the reason why I'm now in the strawweight.
Yeah, well, that's intriguing because that kind of goes into, you know, one of my next questions here. Like, I'm kind of wondering, just being in a, you know, higher weight category, I'm wondering if in the camp there's maybe different, you know, dietary options available, increased strength and conditioning that Meng wasn't able to do before. Like, can she talk about maybe some of those aspects added in with going to this new weight category?
小波，你是不是说就是进入到草量级以后，对于你更好的发挥自己的长处？因为你是一个打击系的，你的重击很强嘛，是不是说把这个体重提上来以后，能够有效的让你在这些你擅长的领域去发挥自己的专长了？我觉得是的，因为我降原子量级的时候，就是降的体重比较多嘛，然后可能会影响我的一些状态，还有一些力量方面，所以我觉得我在草量级能多多能就是比原子量级多发挥自己的优势。
Yeah, I am a striker hitter, and when I used to stay in the autumn weight, every time when I fight, I have to lost a lot of weight, and that actually affected a lot of my condition, my power, my strength. So I think strawweight for me, it
actually helped me to express myself more, because I can swing like how I love to swing. I can punch how I love to punch.
Well, that's intriguing, because I think Meng Bo's, you know, power and just her ability to generate strength in the shots was like one of her big attributes at atomweight. So what she's saying is like that punching power is very much there, but it's able to sustain itself that much more throughout the fight. Is that a fair kind of breakdown?
所以是不是对你来说就是说草量级的你是比起原子量级的你是更好的状态的你呢？
我觉得会是的，然后我也希望是。 因为我还没有尝试嘛，所以我希望这场比赛我能发挥得更好，然后能让自己觉得自己在草量级是更好。Yeah,
the strawweight version of me is definitely going to be a better version of me in the autumn way. Like I said, I'm a striker, and I want to strike harder.
And I mean, this is quite the intriguing matchup for sure. Someone who's contended for that one strawweight title multiple times is currently at the top of the division. Like, when did the bout offer initially come your way, and what were the feelings with that? I imagine there was a lot of excitement getting to fight such a high level contender.
你的对手是有过多次挑战冠军的经验，而且他现在此时此刻他还是。
就是级别的排名第一，你当时在接到这个对手的时候，知道能够在草量级的第一次尝试就面对这样排位的一个选手，你是什么样的心情？能不能描述一下当时的情况？我觉得万给我这个机会，其实我自己也很高兴。然后我觉得对于我打排名第几，或者是我的对手他曾经挑战过冠军几次，这样这。 跟我对我来说没有任何关系，我觉得，这是我进入草量级的第一个挑战，然后也是给我自己的一个机会，给我自己一个重拾信心的一个机会吧。所以他是排名第几，或者是他挑战冠军几次，这个没有任何关系。
Yeah, I'm very grateful for ONE Championship to give me this opportunity. And I think it's actually a very great opportunity for me to stay, to rise myself in the strawweight division. But to be honest, I don't care if my opponent have challenged the title for how many times or how she ranked in the top rankings. I don't see that as a threat or anything. I'm just focusing on myself.
Oh yeah, for sure. It just seems like the big goal is to eventually capture a championship within ONE. And I mean, fighting the number one contender, I imagine, would facilitate getting a title shot thereafter. But it seems like Meng is mostly focusing on this fight, but it's kind of hard to ignore the title implications that exist in this one.
对，但是你的对手他排名第一的话，从某种方面其实也说明就是。
可能你赢下这场比赛以后，那你接下来就是相当于冠军挑战者了，因为排名这个东西它就是存在的意义就是这个嘛。这一点对你来说会不会让你有额外的兴奋，或者说额外的期待呢？我其实没想过这些问题，我只是想打好每一场比赛。然后如果说这场比赛，我可能会有80%的。 赢得几率，但是我也想把所有的心思全花在我目前这场比赛上。如果以后能有挑战冠军的机会，我想我也会全力以赴。Yeah,
I don't think much of what's gonna happen if I beat a top number one ranking, if I could get a title shot or not. I'm just focusing on this match specifically, but also if I could get a title shot right after this, I would be very grateful for sure.
And it seems like based on some previous interviews Meng has done talking about Tiffany, it seems like she sees the striking of Tiffany as something that represents like a big kind of attribute on her end. And we were talking about Meng Bo's desire to want to showcase her prowess and power in the striking there. Like, does she think this is largely going to be a fight where Tiffany indulges her desire to want to stand up, or is there some desire to want to have like Meng Bo show off some of those grappling skills and the work she's done recently?
你再过往其实你也了解这个这次的这个对手张慧文 Tiffany Teo， 你觉得在这场比赛当中他会和你以什么样的一个战术去比赛？因为你刚才有提到说你在准备这个摔柔方面、龙边方面有在对这场比赛有过很强的准备，但是你觉得对手会以什么样的一个方式和你来打这场比赛？
我觉得他可能会很快把我想要把我带入地面吧，因为大家都已经看到了，可能全世界人都知道我的地面和我的龙边不好，所以我觉得他备赛的时候也会特意的会加强会有一些把我带入地面的战术吧。
I think the whole world just saw me from the last fight get finished on the ground. I got good advantage on striking, but then I fall on the ground. I think she probably gonna try to finish me the same way, maybe grab me, wrestle me. That's why I've been preparing a lot for wrestling and grappling. And I think she knows very well how good I punch, how good I strike. So I don't think she will take chance to strike with me. I think it's going to be probably a grappling match, and it's going to probably end on the ground. But it's going to be my hands be right raising.
And something else I was curious about was the, you know, shaving of the head, because that seemed like a particularly symbolic kind of thing that was done after the last fight there. And one of the quotes I saw from the ONE FC article that I was checking out was saying a girl must have the experience of shaving her head in her life. I'm not doing it for others, but to motivate and remind myself. Like, what about shaving your head is like a cathartic, I guess, symbolic thing for you as you continue in your martial arts journey?
记者观察到你在上一场比赛那个结束以后把自己的头发剃掉了，然后呢他又看到那个正好ONE的官方针对你的这个行为写了一篇文章，说那文章里有一句话挺有意思的，说一个女孩没有经历过就是一次给自己剃头剃发就不会真正的那个崛起，当然也是有一种开玩笑幽默在里面吧。想知道你上一次就是把自己的头发剃掉是一个什么样的心态？是不是也是为了激励自己，让自己有一个全新的状态呢？
我觉得我剃头，关于我剃头发这件事情，可能我不是给任何人看的，可能我觉得这是给我自己看的。我需要给我自己一个决心吧，然后让我自己有一个记性，然后去尝试，记住自己当时的那种心态，然后再去前进。
好 ，Yeah, I'm shaving my I was shaving my head because I want to keep in mind of that feeling of how losing feels like. I didn't shave my head to show it to anybody. I'm showing to myself to keep that in mind.
And also, I imagine she's probably in Singapore quarantining right now, or at the very least going to be doing it soon. And it seems like there's a few of those quarantines under the belt. So, like, what does Meng Bo get up to when she's kind of in that fighter hotel quarantining and awaiting fight time?
你现在有到新加坡了吗？他是想问，就是说他想问的是，你在那个到那边以后隔离的时候每天都在干什么？但是我觉得还是先问一下你到那边，因为据我所知，你应该还没到那边。
对，我周日晚上七点多，周日晚上六点多，下午六点多到新加坡。
Yeah, actually, I haven't been to. I was still in China, not in Singapore, and everything just be normal training and sleeping. That's it. I'll be in Singapore in Sunday night.
Yeah, and what's the travel like getting there? Is there like a lot of like testing that has to be done? Is like the traveling a bit of a hassle, or is it largely pretty smooth getting to Singapore?
去的这个
过程，因为你也在疫情期间你也去过几次了，这个过程是比较麻烦的，有很多流程，还是说也你感觉还 OK， 还比较顺利？
我觉得还 OK 吧。然后就是到那儿的时候，就是不能出门嘛，就只能在酒店里待。然后每天会有几个小时出来让你训练，然后练完之后只能在酒店里待，就是觉得很无聊。
Well, I think the traveling is pretty smooth because I actually have already been used to it. I've been to Singapore to fight for a couple of times during the COVID, and I'm quite familiar with the process. And when you get there, you just stay in the hotel and pretty boring. Every day you got a few hours to go out and train or do something you want to do. That's it. And you just wait for fight, and after it, get money and go home.
Yeah, and with it being January and stuff like that, a lot of people, you know, tend to make New Year's resolutions. Does Meng Bo have any resolutions throughout the new year here, like any particular goals she's looking to actualize into reality for 2022?
你在2022年有没有一些就是自己立的这个目标？就是很多人在新的一年会给自己定下一些新的想达到的东西，在新历年你有没有同样的一些感悟想要完成的事呢？
我觉得我的目标，我现在的目标就是打好每一场比赛吧。
嗯，有没有一个整个一年，然后一年中，然后最后想要实现一个，最后在今年结束的时候想要达到一个什么样的一个结果？
我去年想要拿到去年的目标是想要拿到原子量级冠军，然后今年升级别了，我再想拿到草量级冠军。反正就是想打好每一场比赛吧。现在说不太想说那些话了。
嗯。Well, at the beginning of the last year, I said I'm gonna be the Atomweight world champion for sure, and now I'm at strawweight. I don't want to say that I'm going to be the strawweight world champion at the end of the year. I don't want to say anything like that anymore, but I want to say that I don't want to lose any fights in this year. I want to have a perfect win streak to close the career of this year and start a whole new career of next year.
Yeah, I think that's a good way to look at it. But something I kind of wanted to talk about too, I mean, this is more of like a hypothetical kind of thing almost, just with, you know, Zhang Jingnan defending her title against Ayaka Miura on the same event here. And it seems like there's a lot of respect for Jingnan and just what she's been able to do for growing Chinese mixed martial arts. So just in like the purely hypothetical sense of if you were to fight Zhang Jingnan for that strawweight championship, like how much would that mean to you just on the level of inspiring women in China to, you know, go on their own journey within martial arts and just really inspire them to want to learn all of that?
他想问一个，就是现在来看可能还不是很那个确切的，但是因为你现在已经选择了草量级，然后你在和这个熊劲男同样的级别作战，你们也是相识很久了，他作为草量级的冠军也为那个中国卫冕了无数次的金腰带，你有没有想过就是说要有朝一日去挑战他，然后呢如果能够和他站在同台去竞赛去争夺同一条金腰带，对你来说会意味着什么？
我曾经我其实最大的目标是什么？我其实最大的目标不是只是熊劲男那条腰带，我想要的是原子量级跟草量级两条腰带。所以我觉得现在应该怎么说这件事情？我觉得如果说。我跟南姐，我俩如果真的能碰上的话，我觉得我们俩可能 都会全力以赴的，然后场上是场上，场下还是场下，还是会是朋友。所以虽然说两个中国人争一条腰带，但是我觉得，会有一天两条腰带都会属于中国的。
Yeah, I'm very willing to see one day the two Chinese women fighting for a world title belt, and I want to show that fight to all the Chinese fans. But also, I think the sister Nan is an idol of me, and I always admire her. And I gotta be honest, I think in the near future, both the Atomweight World Belt and the Strawweight World Belt will all be in the hold of Chinese person. No matter if it's going to be me for Atomweight, Xiong for Strawweight, or both in my hand, no matter what.
Yeah, well, I was actually taking part in a panel with South China Morning Post the other day there, and a lot of the panelists, myself included, really liked your chances in this strawweight category. And some of the panelists outright picked you to be the strawweight champion by the end of the calendar year. Do you take that as a complimentary thing, like any of these like surrounding kind of perceptions, or do you try to, I guess, block out the noise, as it were, and just focus on the task at hand kind of thing?
他说他在与这个包括南华早报的 MMA 频道啊等等，很多这个媒体，他们之前有在一起做一个对2022年的年终预测，然后发现就是很多啊，就是很大概率的这个媒体专业人士其实都有把你就是写为这个预测在2022年年终前会成为草量级世界冠军的人。你怎么看待他们的这种评价？他们的这种预测，你是否会觉得这是一个对你的一个褒奖？然后你会不会就是很在意这种外界对你的看法？
我不在意外界对我的任何看法。然后我觉得他们这样预测可能会对我的期望会很大吧。所以我觉得对我的期望越大，我觉得我可能努力的就越多，所以也感谢他们那么支持我，然后我觉得我会努力达到他们所期盼的那样。
Yeah, I'm actually very grateful, and I think the more you guys expect me to be the champion or to be the better version of myself, the more I am possible to be that better version of myself. And I actually hope that I could actually be there as you guys predicted, and I think I could be.
Yeah, great to, have a positive mentality and stuff like that, and just, yeah, fun career to follow. But I'm kind of curious because I'd seen an article saying that Meng Bo is the youngest of four sisters, and it seems like maybe, dad gets all fired up at the fights, maybe mom's like a little nervous kind of thing. But I'm kind of curious, like, what Meng Bo's sisters think of her pursuit as a fighter and just what she's been able to do in her MMA career.
他有读到，就是说，你好像是你们家里面姐妹里面的最年轻的一个，最小的一个，在这样的家庭里面成长，然后如今成为了这样一位世界顶级的这种格斗项目的运动员，是一个什么样的经历呢？你和家人，比如说你的姐姐们是如何看待你的职业，然后你的家人们是如何就是支持或者说处理你作为这样一个运动员的这种事情呢？
其实一开始，我们家里人都是不同意的。然后，慢慢，其实自己坚持下来了之后，看到成就了，然后家里人也觉得你，确实是适合走这条路，然后确实是想要走这条路的时候，大家都会支持你。所以一开始是不同意，但是到现在他们是很支持我的。
Well, at the beginning, none of my family members agreed for me to be an MMA fighter for sure, because I'm the youngest girl. But since I insist and nobody could stop me, and now I become start fighting in the world stage and have a very good performance, good record, everybody start to support me, my family, my friends, and I think now they all see me as their pride, and think I'm very happy for that.
Well, that's an awesome thing to hear, and I'm really appreciative of the time overall, but I want to be mindful of Meng Bo's schedule too. So is there anything she might want to add kind of as a parting thought as we're wrapping up here?
小波今天的采访差不多就到这里结束了，你在最后有什么想说的吗？想对那个包括他的这个频道的受众，有什么想说的？
我希望就是大家都要支持 中国综合格斗，尤其是综合格斗，就是女生综合格斗。然后还有就是我感谢你们那么支持我，然后我也希望我自己能达到你们所期盼。谢谢，thank you。
I hope that I'm very grateful for everybody, my fans, my all the people watching me around the world for supporting me, and I want people to support more on China MMA, and especially China women MMA, and we will be better, and we will not fail you guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for the time, and I'm really looking forward to this fight. We're just a week out as of this recording. One Heavy Hitters featuring Tiffany Teo versus Meng Bo. And yeah, to reiterate, thanks to both of you for the time, and yeah, just both of you have a great rest of your day too.
Hey, thank you, Dylan.